All right, hello. Now that I've completed all the daily challenges that I have, or that I'm eligible to complete, figured I'd do something I don't think I've done, and that's go through all my cars, all my NASCAR related cars. So up first to number one, obviously, Steve Hart and Flash Gibson, Pennzoil DEI Chevrolet, one of the iconic looks of late 90s and early 2000s NASCAR. It wasn't the luckiest number. Unfortunately, poor Steve Park had a lot of problems driving that car. DW got a resurgence kind of in that car. That's the first one. And then this is the most recent one I've done. The Daytona. Buddy Baker Daytona. Really a super bird. But very minimal changes make it a Superbird, or take it from a Superbird to a Dodge Daytona. This is the Cotton Owens car that he drove in the 60s, late 60s. I believe that's the car he broke the 200 mile an hour barrier with. And then this one, Derek Cope's 1990 Daytona 500. Obviously, 1990, the year Dale Earnhardt was destined to win, it seemed. And then Rick Wilson had cut a tire. No, Rick Wilson broke a transmission, and Dale Earnhardt ran over the bell housing, cut the tire, and Derek Cope got the win. And of course, the iconic King Richard Superbird. Obviously, it's not exact to what the King Superbird was. Kind of a tribute overall to the King. Because it's got the STP logos on the side of it. Some of the stuff I had to put on, like the Petty. They didn't have any. I couldn't find anything Petty Enterprises, so I had to make Richard Petty. I had to stick Richard Petty Motorsports stuff on it. But yeah, that's that one. I've raced that one a bunch, so. This is another recent one. Super K, Kenny Schrader's M&M's number 36 that he drove from 2000 to 2002 for the MB2 Motorsports team. Everybody loves Schrader. That's why I made it. I mean, who doesn't love Ken Schrader? This one was a car for myself. Bobby Hamilton Sr. He drove this car with this livery 2001. And then the car was black and green in 2002. And then for 03, Bobby went back down to the truck series. And Kenny Wallace also drove that car, but that's mainly a Bobby Hamilton-esque scheme. Next on to Bobby Allison and the number 22. This was really a Dodge Daytona. I'm sure that he ran. Okay, well. Oh wait, I had a brain fart. I was gonna say, okay, why is this car have columns? And why do those other two have column shifts? Because those were Plymouths. Yeah, Bobby Allison drove this car in 1969, maybe 1970. I don't have the stats in front of me, so, but 22 was kind of the number that was synonymous with Bobby for a long time, and the Coca-Cola red and gold Dodge. One of those iconic early NASCAR looks. And then Budweiser and Dale Earnhardt Jr. Little Italy, not really too much detail. The Chronicles of Little E are well known. Next up, J.D. McDuffie. Pontiac. This was a car I had to make all of the decals that are on this race car. And I would share them if I knew how, but I didn't. So, unfortunately. Yeah, J.D. McDuffie in the history books for a few different things. Most starts without a win, most top tens without a win. I believe. Oh gosh, what was the other one? Well, oh yeah. For a long time, he held the record for most last place finishes without a win. That record has since been surpassed by Michael McDowell. JD, it was a well-loved guy, and next up, Dick Trickle. The Miller High Life car that he won Rookie of the Year in for the Stavola brothers at the age of 48. That is a record that will never be broken. Because most guys are retiring before the age of 48, and most guys now are getting their start in a cup car, between 18 and 20. And 20 to 22, maybe. Because trucks, they can start at 16 and run about half of the schedule. But yeah, this is the Buick that Dick Trickle drove for his rookie season. On to the next one, Dave Marcus, another lovable independent racer. Number 71 Realtree was a well-loved car of the late 90s, dear friend to Dale Earnhardt. Dave had the, or no, he still does have the record for most consecutive starts, most consecutive attempts, and most starts overall in the Daytona 500. He held the record for oldest starter of the Daytona 500 until 2018, and then Mark Thompson in a one-off for Carl Long took that record. And I just threw the RCR sticker on there because he did a lot of work for RCR, testing and whatnot. Next up, it's really a Toyota Supra, but I turned it into the Ward Burton Caterpillar Dodge. Why? Because I felt like it. Ward Burton, of course. Who doesn't love Ward? He's like, who doesn't love Ward? Can't understand half the crap that comes out of his mouth sometimes, but he had a blunt, no-nonsense attitude, and I did my best to try to create his 2002-2003 Caterpillar Dodge that he drove for Bill Davis. Next up, what was? I don't know. I'm still not pleased with this. There's there's more that can be done to it that needs to be done to it. But it's just been kind of a slow. Based off of his late 90s car. I need to add white to the front end. You know, I have the hood painted white, but right here on the fender needs to be white. Decals would probably be smart. But, and obviously the Team Penske logo is not accurate, but, because at the time, let's see, it was Penske Kranifas, and then Penske Racing South for a while before it became Team Penske. Next up, Buddy Arrington. This is another car that I had originally done cheesy crap, and then I went and made my set of decals for it. Buddy's longtime sponsors of Jim Peacock Dodge, Reed's Trailer Sales, and Buddy, they actually did a feature on Buddy this past weekend during the Martinsville Cup race, which was nice. He's from Martinsville, Virginia, and you know, he gets a lot of coverage, you know, amongst YouTubers and whatnot, but he never doesn't get a ton of mainstream NASCAR coverage, and so it was nice to see them and talk to his son too, a little bit. Next up, another Super B, Marty Robbins, the country music legend who became he was a singer who raced. Of course, Marty Robbins from 1950 till his death in 1982. He was a big hit maker on the country music scene, and then in the 60s he got into NASCAR and almost always drove a yellow and pink or yellow and purple car. Number 42 was a frequent number. He had a number 6 as well, but 42 was typically Buddy's number, or his dirt car was 777. I like Marty Robbins singing, and it just seemed appropriate to. This was the first Daytona I made, I think. And the name on the side and stuff, I had to custom make that stuff too. Let's see, up next, Storm and Norm. Please, developers, put a Chevy in this game. Please. I want a Chevy truck in this game. But anyway, Norm Benning, the ultimate underdog. It's weird that I did my best to try to cover all the Toyota stuff on the outside with Chevrolet stuff. You can't really customize the interior in this game. But this is a salute to Norm's Eldora truck from the inaugural dirt race there, when he defied all odds and nearly got wrecked into the wall multiple times. He was smushed into the wall multiple times by Clay Grinfeld. Okay, who's next? Front Row Joe number 1. The U.S. Army Chevrolet. It's a little bit different than what the actual car looked like, just because you're limited in space and the designs of the cars. Messes with you too, but Joe Nemechek, he's my favorite driver. Always has been, always will be. And, you know, the U.S. Army car was So that was probably some of the best driving, or that was probably the best car that he had. Yeah, he drove for Hendrick, but the 25 car was always kind of Hendrick's. It was the fourth car out of the four. And there was three or four races in 2005 that Joe should have won driving this car. Spring at Auto Club. Michigan number one, no, Michigan number two, and the Coca-Cola 600. Fontana won, the car blew. Yeah, the car blew up. Cut a tire leading the Coca-Cola 600 with like 15 or 20 laps to go. That one was painful. And then he cut another tire while leading at Michigan. He still rallied for a top 10 in that one, but oh, he should have won. Not a NASCAR, but the Golden Greek is my favorite NHRA guy. Chris Caramassini's. This is supposed to kind of be his. Oh, I can just. There we go. Hold the camera, or change the camera myself. The silver is obviously supposed to be modeled after his iconic 200 mile an hour braking dragster, the Chisler. And then he also had gold plated cars, so that's where the gold paint and gold wheels comes in. This is another one where I had to sit there and make the decal, most of the decals, the Strange Engineering stuff, and Lucas Oil and NHRA logo. Somebody else made, so whoever did, thanks. But yeah, it seemed like I felt like doing that one just to change it up a little bit, and then because he's my favorite guy. And on to this, ugh, I was gonna say the Sterling Bullet, the Silver Bullets driven by Sterling Marlin. This is the car, when you think of Coors and NASCAR, this is the car that comes to mind. Sterling had some of the best success of his career driving this scheme. For Chip Ganassi, the mountains on the side, the big Coors on the hood, and yeah, he was on track to win that 2002 championship, but then he got that neck injury, and he was never the same. Seems like when guys have a major injury like that, they're never quite the same. And he just, Oh, and then, Jamie McMurray got into that car too and won in his second start. And on to the Joni Machek number 25 for Hendrick. This was the car, when I started getting into NASCAR, this was the car Joe was driving. And obviously it's a Nissan, but quite a few of these are Nissans that I put Chevrolet badging on, but yeah, that's that one. And Cale Yarborough, I did this one right after Cale passed away. This was not a car I had planned on making, but then I had a Pontiac that I was originally going to do for a J.B. McDuffie car, and then Cale Yarborough ended up passing away at the very end of 2022, and so I built this one for kind of in his honor. 1983, he's qualified on the pole. Lap number two, he's going for more, and the car flips, and they were unable to get the. NASCAR was going to allow them to rebuild the Monte Carlo. And then crew chief Waddell Wilson said no, and he got his son to drive to a Hardee's. Now, there's kind of a misconception It was a straight show car. It was not a show car. It was a race car. It was a full-blown race car on display as a show car, for a Hardee's restaurant. And so they went to wherever that Hardee's was. I think they said it was in Georgia. And the rest is history. He won 2 years in a row in that car at Daytona. And of course, my man, Morgan Shepherd. Morgan has always been one of my favorite drivers. I would like to do more with this car. It's not quite right, but I'm limited with what I can do. The Fleetwood RV is not accurate. That was not a sponsor of his. Bizone, Bizone, whatever the, however you pronounce it, they are the correct sponsor that would be on this car. But this is his. This would be his 51st anniversary car. The 50th anniversary car just had the gold hood and the gold top. It didn't have the gold all the way around the front end. So yeah, that's his 51st anniversary car. And off to the almighty Intimidator, Big E. What more can be said about the iconic black number three? This car could probably, I'm tempted to do a little bit more to it decal wise, but at the same time, I just like, the good wrench service plus on the side with the three and then the signature. I don't want to put any more decals or anything on it, and I backed out and I didn't want to back out. Sometimes it tries. There we go. And now, the bandit, Handsome Harry. I know a guy who has a friend who has Harry's 1989 Old Thunder. It wasn't a Burton Hal car, but obviously this is supposed to be modeled after Burton Hal's school bandit, Burt Reynolds, and Hal Needham. Another one of those iconic NASCAR schemes of the 80s and the 90s. This car was around for a long time. Harry drove it in the 80s and through 94. Then Robert Presley drove it in 95 and I think 96. And then Super K Schrader took over from 97 through 99. And then the 33 Skoal left, and the 33 got sponsored by Oakwood Homes in 2000, and Joe Nemechek drove that car. James Harvey Hilton. Such an unfortunate loss in 2018 when Harvey Hilton in that truck accident. Obviously, this was also a Daytona, but I didn't have the option at the time for a Super Bird, so I made it a Super B. James Hilton, another one of the legendary independents. I think he's got to be the only guy in NASCAR that has a perfect top 10 to start, or not, I shouldn't say perfect, but he made 602 starts and he scored 301 top 10 finishes. He hung around in the ARCA series for a very long time, was still active in ARCA with driver Brad Smith when he was killed. Unfortunately, and ooh, I do have a. Sorry, I'm getting off topic here for a minute. I forgot. I was going to go buy that Daytona, but now I might not. Or did I say Daytona? I meant Super B. And lastly, Bobby Gearhart in a Chevy that's another Nissan. Bobby Gearhart in ARCA a legend of Daytona and Talladega, primarily Daytona. 8 wins, 2 different occasions, 3 in a row. Technically, Bobby is still... he's still around. He still has a race car. It just doesn't have the... Ever since he retired because of... he suffered a heart attack. Ever since he retired, Lucas Oil pulled their support. And so... He hasn't been back, unfortunately. But yeah, those are all of them. All of the NASCAR stuff. This car here, I have an idea of where I want to go with it. But I want to make sure that I can. Nope, that's not what I want. Decals, yes. Nope, shite. Mick Griff. Shoot. Go 04. That's not... This is not very helpful. Okay, so this is going to end up being a car that I'm going to have to make decals for. Because none of this stuff is what I want. The idea that I had was a Herschel McGriff... 04 car, but I'm gonna have to scratch that idea, I think. Yeah, I'm gonna have to scratch that one. Close. Excuse me. I haven't done this much talking on a video in a while. So, with that being the scenario, I'm going to go take a peek in used cars and see what else is in here. Oh, is that that thing that I need for that? You know what? I think I need this car for that one race. Oh god, look at this. That is an ugly little car. No, I do not want to get into that thing right yet. Super B. There are no cars in here that I want to spend money on to do what I was thinking. I would rather spend money on the actual make of car. With what I'm thinking. What are the options for Ford? Because there's a few Fords I could go with. Let's see, Chevy. You know what? I'm gonna go with Chevy. But I'm not gonna go with a normal Chevy. I'm going with a... Well, actually, what's the price difference? If it's not a big difference, then I'm just going to go Nova. Okay, I'm going with this one. Bobby Labonte shared recently, or yesterday, today.
Yes.
He announced it today. His and Terry's father, Bob Labonte Sr., two-time championship-winning owner in the Xfinity Series, passed away at the age of 91. And so, if Labonte schemes, if Labonte Racing schemes are, if a Labonte Racing scheme is possible, that's what I'm going with. Gotta look up the Slim Jim number 44. The car was yellow and red. Bobby won the championship driving that car in 91, and then David Green in 94. Labonte Racing 44. And it's showing me pictures of Terry Labonte's 44 car, Piedmont car that he drove for Billy Hagan. Slim Jim. Labonte Racing Slim Jim. There we go. Okay, so yellow or red car with a yellow base. So that's phase one. Paint it. Just going kind of a generic red. I'm not going to put a fancy red because it doesn't look like a fancy red on there. Decals. I need a black and yellow? Or is it just straight yellow? Come on, get bigger. Get bigger! There we go. Okay, black and then yellow. So, I think it wraps around the whole car. This is where it gets a little tricky. Okay, so I should have changed the color before I... Actually, you know what? No, I am gonna just make it. Duplicate that one. Okay. So black. What did I paint black? I didn't paint anything black. There we go. Okay. Duplicate on opposite side. These two need to be black. Okay, now I need to make yellow. So let's see here. Go to number one, duplicate, color, yellow, goldish yellow. Nah, it's kind of a bright yellow. Yeah. Bump it down, bump it down, bump it down. Nice. Duplicate on opposite side. Move. Up. There we go. Now. Duplicate. Yellow. Bump it down. Duplicate. Ah, shoot! I didn't want to do that. Frick bucket. Yellow. Bump it down. Okay. Now, to hope, I'm pretty sure I have come across these. Well, there's Terry's 44. Come on, Slim Jim 44. Come on, Slim Jim. NY Racing 44. I guess if I have to, it's two Morgan McClure 44s that are the same font. So I could, because I know that the Morgan McClure 4s are in here somewhere. PPI font in number 44. There was never a PPI 44. I know that there was talk of reviving the PPI 44 in 2004 because Joe Nemechek was supposed to, or was possibly going to drive that car. And then Cal Wells ended up firing. No. He decided not to do it, and then towards the end of the 04 season, fired Ricky Craven. Hired Bobby Hamilton Jr. That was a stupid move. Because that team was already kind of meh. But they really became meh when Bobby Jr. took that car over. Yep, it's looking like I'm going to have to double up on the Morgan McClures. Because I am not seeing what I want to be seeing. Petty Enterprise 44. When NY was Team Extreme. Wow, I forgot that TriStar had a... TriStar did have a 44. That's right. Okay, I'm going to try one more idea. See if Labonte, what Labonte does. Labonte. Nope. UPS. Okay. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get off the mic here, and I'm gonna focus on this because trying to talk and think is. Labonte 44, that's what I'm going for.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Bye.